Hi, I'm Kim McIntosh and I teach biology at Shadow Mountain High School. And today we're going to talk about Mendel, and we're going to look at the hypothesis that he generated from his experiments on pea plants. So one of the first things that he figured out from his thousands of experiments with pea plants was that there was a dominant trait and a recessive trait. We now know that those traits are carried on the alleles that are in the chromosomes. So if you'll look right here, these are homologous chromosomes. So this might be the chromosome from dad, and this might be the chromosome from mom. But what we see is they each have an allele. This one has the allele for purple flowers, and this one has the allele for white flowers. And what Mendel found out was that purple flowers are dominant to white flowers. So with this allele pair, the flowers on that plant are going to be purple because this dominant allele is there. And whenever the dominant allele is there, the recessive is not expressed. Only the dominant is expressed in the flowers. So we have some naming systems for this. And in this situation, we have a recessive allele for blue eyes, and we have a dominant allele for brown eyes. And what happens is the dominant allele is expressed, but we call this combination heterozygous. Heterozygous means different, so they have different alleles. So they have the one allele for blue eyes, the one allele for brown eyes. It's a heterozygous combination of alleles, but the dominant is going to be expressed. Now in this one, we see that there's two brown-eyed alleles. So we call this homozygous dominant. So homozygous means they're the same. So they have the same alleles. They both have the allele for brown eye color. And so brown eyes is what that individual is going to have. This one is also homozygous, but we call this homozygous recessive because both the blue eyed alleles are there. So there's two recessive alleles there. So this individual is going to have blue eyes, and we call this homozygous recessive. Mendel also figured out that alleles segregate randomly. And what this means is that when these alleles line up on the metaphase plate during meiosis, it's random as to how they line up. Now it shows that this chromosome is here in this position, but it could have just as easily been in any of these other places. So there's no pattern to how they line up. It's completely random. And so when those sister chromatids split and they go into these gametes, it's a random process. It can go into any one of these gametes. And each time that it splits, it could be different. So it's completely random how those alleles go into the gametes because of how they line up in metaphase. All right, we use allele codes. It's kind of a shorthand for us. So what we do is we look at the dominant trait, and in the case of these rabbits, black fur is dominant to white fur. And so we would use a capital B to indicate that dominant trait, and we would use a lowercase b to indicate the recessive trait. So even though the recessive trait is white fur, we're not going to use a lowercase w. We're going to stick with that b. And so we have a capital B indicates black fur, and a lowercase b indicates white fur. And you'll notice that it's the same here. The dominant trait is short-haired fur, so we use a capital S to indicate that dominant trait. The recessive trait is long-haired fur, and so we would use a lowercase s to indicate that recessive trait. Now let's talk about genotype and phenotype. The genotype is just the letter combinations. Okay, so here the genotype for blue eyes is going to be lowercase b, and that's going to indicate blue eyes. The genotype for brown eyes could be capital B, lowercase b, or it could be capital B, but the genotype is the letter combinations. Phenotype is what actually shows up in the individual. So this individual has blue eyes. This individual has brown eyes. So you'll notice that genotype and phenotype, they kind of tell us the same thing. The phenotype is blue eyes. The genotype is lowercase b, which tells us that the phenotype is going to be blue eyes. Mendel also looked at dihybrid crosses. So what we've talked about up to this point is monohybrid, but dihybrid means two traits. And so Mendel crossed two different traits together. So he did this with yellow seeds, so that's one trait for color, and then he crossed seed shape, so he crossed round with wrinkled. Yellow and green and round with wrinkled. And what this told him was that those traits are independent of each other. So just because you start with a yellow round seed doesn't mean that yellow and round are connected together. So you can just as easily have a green round seed as a yellow round seed. All right, so we now know that some traits are linked on the genes. So this diagram shows the 23 chromosomes that humans have. And so if we look at, say, chromosome 12, it has genes on it. The different colors represent the different genes. And those genes are not necessarily linked, but what we find is that if they are close on the chromosome, then they're probably linked together. But if they're far away on the chromosome, like the yellow and this dark green down here, they're less likely to be linked. The farther away they are, they don't have an impact on each other. And we also see that the X and the Y chromosomes indicate whether it's a male or a female. So males have an X and a Y chromosome. Females have two X chromosomes. So if you have an X and a Y chromosome, you're a male. If you don't have a Y chromosome and instead you have two X chromosomes, you're a female.